Good evening, and welcome to this auspicious production by the NHS Theatre Company of She Kills Monsters. Before it starts, we need to tell you a few things. There will be one 15-minute intermission in the middle of the play, wherein you will have the opportunity to eat some good food and drink tasty drinks at our concession stand, and that will support the department. Please don't forget that to record this production in any way is prohibited by law. At this time, please do us all a favor and turn off your cell phones, your pagers, your digital watches, or anything else in your pockets that might be vibrate, flash in the dark, or just make creepy sounds. All right, sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
Head on.
And here, in the land of Ohio, during the year of 1995, one of the rarest types of geek walks the earth. A dungeon master without fear, prejudice, or a penis. This nerd was a girl nerd, the most uncommon form of nerd in the world. And her name was Tilly Evans.
Found a way out. I'm looking for Chuck Biggs.
You're looking at him. But my homies just call me simply DM Biggs. Because, you know, I'm big where it counts. As in my brain.
Oh.
Not because I'm fat. Seriously, it has nothing to do with my body mass index. I'm actually in pretty good shape.
I get it.
So what can I do you for?
Rumor has it you know a thing or two about D&D.
Well, that depends. Are we talking first or second edition? Sight! It doesn't matter which, because my D&D IQ is the bomb! So, what do you need, Miss Pretty Eyes?
I have this thing, and I'm not really quite sure what it is.
Let me check it out for you.
You know, you're not exactly what I was expecting.
What? Were you expecting some nerd? Because I'm no nerd. I'm a straight-up lady killer. Yeah, I have a girlfriend. She's not from around here, though. She lives up in New York.
And you know what they say about them New York honeys.
Them girlies are crazy. You've been to New York, right?
No.
I've been there. Seen the Statue of Liberty, Empire State Building, Hard Rock Cafe. Pretty awesome.
Is that where you met your girlfriend?
Met? Well, we haven't officially met. I mean, in person. We met on the internet. You've been on the internet, right?
Yeah, we have it at work.
Seriously, you gotta get hooked up at home. I have crazy fast connections at my digs. My parents' digs. I'm talking 56 kilobits per second. Fastest on the market, yo.
For reals.
So about my notebook.
Oh, right. It appears to be a homestone module.
What's that?
It's like a map for a D&D game. An adventure, and this one looks like it's set for 1 to 2 players at entry-level skills and power destinations and, whoa! Wait just a minute!
What?
Tilius the Paladin? Was this written by Tilly Evans?
You know her?
You kidding, right? Every player here in Athens has been on a campaign with her. How'd you get a hold of this?
She's my sister.
Oh. Man. I'm sorry.
So, can you help me figure out what this all means?
Sure, but there's something I should tell you up front now that I know who you are.
Okay.
Nothing can happen between us, okay? I know you were vibing on it all when we first met. Now that I know who you are, I don't think it'd be appropriate.
All right.
what do you want to do with this module?
Well, Chuck, I want to play it. With all of this.
Man, your sister's really some geeky things.
Yeah.
I'm sure you don't want any help. You know I'm strong, right? Like, boom!
We're also clumsy, like ass.
I'm not clumsy.
Should I remind you of my former coffee table?
It was a faulty design.
Thanks for the help, babe, but you should go. I should really practice myself. I'm her sister. It's part of the job.
All right, then. I'll just start moving boxes over to our new place.
That sounds like a good idea. Just don't drop anything.
Love you.
I love you, too.
You should try talking to Agnes. And, I mean, about all of this, I think it'll help.
Where would I even start?
Try asking her.
Okay. Okay, Tilly, so where do I begin?
You're going to suck at this.
Tilly?
You don't even know the difference between a mage or a wizard.
Hey, trust me. I rather wish you would have left a diary or a journal, but no! Instead, I get a model.
Module.
Module, whatever. So how do I do this?
You're going to die 5 seconds into it.
Well, you're already dead, so at least we'll have that in common.
Fine. You want to do this? Then let's do this.
Chuck, go.
Greetings, adventurers! I'm Chuck Biggs, also known as DM Biggs, due to the fact that my brain is big.
Not because I'm fat. Seriously, it has nothing to do with my body mass index. Actually been at working out.
Yeah.
Chuck!
Oh, and I will be your dungeon master for this venture. Are you ready?
Fine. If you're serious about this, then you're going to have to meet the rest of the team.
What team?
Every adventurer has a party. This one's mine. Cue the intro music! First up, Lilith Morningstar. Demon Queen.
What in the bad word is she wearing?
She acts as our squad's muscle. Whenever you're surrounded by an armada of ogres, she's the one you want holding the battle axe. She has so much power, she can make an Umbra Hulk shake in its oversized boots. She's the perfect combination of both beauty and brawn.
Violence makes me hot.
Next up, Calliope Darkwalker. Class, Dark Elf. Far with her natural elven agilities, athleticism, and awesomeness, she's also a master tracker. Lockpicker has more than a few magical surprises up her non-existent sleeves.
I'm in the mood for some danger.
And then there's...
Pause. Chuck?
Yeah, what's up?
What is this?
This is your party.
My party is a leather-clad dominatrix and an elven supermodel?
Hey, don't look at me. This is what your sister wrote.
Then how come it screams adolescent boy? I mean, really. Violence makes me hot. Who says that?
Okay, so there's definitely a certain amount of improv involved. But I swear, this is the gist of what Tilly created.
This?
Yes, this.
My sister wrote this?
Look, do you want to play the game or not?
Sure, whatever.
And then...
There's me. I'm the brains of this operation. Name, Tilly Evans, a.k.a. Tillius the Paladin, healer of the wounded, defender of the lights. Class, awesome.
Welcome to the quest for the lost soul of Athens. Your mission is to find and free the lost soul before it is devoured by the dark forces of darkness. Forever!
Seriously? You guys are supposed to be a team of badasses? You look ridiculous.
Unfortunately, neither Lilith nor I can accompany you, for no magical creatures are allowed into his lair unless they risk being entrapped there forever.
Seriously, There has to be more to this outfit, right?
You look like you'd be delicious with the side of a baby.
We're not going to be friends.
Oh, my heart is broken by that news.
Okay, let's go.
Actually, Agnes, before we can go any further, we're going to have to equip you and build you a character. I mean, you can't walk around looking like that.
I'm not wearing what she's wearing.
You're going to at least need a shield.
Shield I can do.
So what will be your environment?
My what?
Are you good, lawful, chaotic, unlawful, evil?
I'm a Democrat.
I guess a sword? Just a regular sword, like that one.
This is not a regular sword.
You have to earn a weapon like the one Tilius wields.
The Eastern Blade of the Dreamwalker.
Forged by the fiery nightmares of God.
Blessed by the demons of Penya.
And bestowed upon the one who once banished the Tiamat from Newlandia.
So I can't have a sword like that one?
No!
Okay, then I will just take a regular sword.
And what will be your name?
Agnes.
No, I mean, what will be your character name?
Agnes.
Stop being such an asshat, Agnes!
I just want to use my name. Agnes.
Fine. Then it is decided. You shall be Agnes the Ass-Hatted.
That's not what I said.
Agnes the Ass-Hatted, welcome to our party.
And so, it was that Agnes the Ass-Hatted and Tilius the Paladin ventured forth into the dark dwellings of the truly evil. Large in stature, Orcus, the overlord of the underworld, in search for the lost soul of Athens. But what they found deep in that cave is not what they were prepared for in the least bit.
It is I, Tilius the Paladin, healer of the wounded, defender of the light, and I've come here
too. Not gonna fight you.
He's not gonna fight us?
We've come here to do battle.
I know what you came here to do, and I'm telling you, I'm busy.
This is the overlord of the underworld?
Former overlord of the underworld. I quit.
You quit? You can't quit!
What are you talking about, I can't quit? You know how annoying it is to get attacked by adventurers all day and night?
To do battle!
You see what I'm talking about?
I have come to claim
Here you go, little man. It's all yours.
Really? That's all I had to do.
Awesome! So, what would you like? Treasure, jewels, some keys with? It's hella good.
I wish to free a soul.
With what?
Mine.
What?
You heard me, Orcus. I want my soul back.
Wait, you're the lost soul of Athens?
Shh.
Okay. Well, this is a bit awkward. I sort of lost your soul.
How is this possible?
Well, I traded it for this badass TV VCR combo from the Tiamat.
You what?
Well, she was totally into it, and my old TV completely cocked out.
So you just gave my soul to the Tiamat?
Well, it is a TV and VCR.
This isn't good, right?
No, not good at all.
Do you want an STD? No, you don't. At worst, that shit'll kill you. Now get out of here. Stupid ass mushroom.
Thank you.
mystery man.
It's not what you think. I was hanging with a high school boy.
Say what?
We were up all night role-playing.
Maybe you should stick to guys your own age.
Jesus, Vera, we were playing Dungeons and Dragons.
Dungeons and Dragons? You know that's a nerd's game, right?
Nerds? Really? Vera, you've got to be like the worst high school guidance counselor ever.
No, I'm not.
Hey, Miss Martin, I was wondering if
no.
Martin?
Are you flunking out of a class?
No.
Then you're fine. Come back later. I'm busy.
Okay.
Wait!
Yes?
Well, I'm sorry, I stand corrected. You should lead workshops on pedagogy.
And how does Miles feel about Dungeons and Dragons?
Really don't like him, do you?
You two have been together for how long? 5 years? And all he's done is ask you to move in with him. Oh, please, son, keep your house. Show me a ring.
I'm not ready for that.
That's because deep down you know he's no good for you.
Can we change the subject, please?
So what's up with this game? Is it some kind of dorky quarter-life crisis?
I'm not stupid. I guess I'm just curious as to why Tilly liked it so much.
And
I honestly don't see what's the appeal. It's actually kind of mundane. All we've done so far is walk around and talk to things.
Suddenly, three bugbears surround you!
What?
Three bugbears surround you!
What the hell is a bugbear?
What do you do?
What do? I don't know what a bugbear is. Are they small? Are they bears?
You examine the bugbears. They're neither small nor bears.
So this game is mundane, huh? All we do is talk and walk.
I didn't know things were suddenly going to jump out at us.
The first bugbear strikes!
Ow! Wait, don't I get a turn?
You wasted your turn examining the bugbear!
Which they appreciate. Bugbears aren't just getting so much attention. The first bugbear strikes!
Well, that's us!
You've been damaged.
Oh, really?
What do you do?
I fight back.
My character doesn't sit.
And?
Tilius easily slays one of the bugbears.
Yeah, that's right. Now it's my turn.
You are swing.
Oh!
And miss.
What? Look at that thing. How did I miss that?
The second bugbear strikes. Next.
Okay. Okay, let me think.
You take a turn to think!
No, I don't!
The third bugbear strikes! Huge damage! Agnes is down!
Your character is dying, Agnes! What do you want to do?
What can I do?
Start playing this game correctly?
How?
Stop acting like a sarcastic ogre all the damn time and I'll help you? Can you do that for me?
Agnes?
Yeah, I can do that.
You promise?
Yes, I promise. What are you doing?
Tilly is using a revive spell to regain Agnes' hit points. You get back on your feet.
We stand side by side and raise our weapons.
Yeah. And this is what happens next. You defeated the bugbears! Agnes levels up!
Yeah.
Less of a dumbass.
Is that really a stat?
Yep, it totally is. You're less dumb. Now, where's the rest of our team?
Cannot be serious, Bob. We're not actually bringing Orvis along, correct?
I must agree with Lilith. Getting the worst demon in all the underworld to turn along with us does seem less than wise.
I totally agree. I mean, have you seen me? I'm red, I've got horns, I'm evil. Do you really want that kind of badness toting along with you?
You're coming with us.
Damn it! You're gonna make me miss Quantum
Leap.
Inconsequential! Have you ever seen Quantum Leap? The dude time travels through time by leaping into different bodies. Different bodies, yo! And put things right that once went wrong. Hoping that each next leap will be his leap home.
That actually does sound interesting.
My soul, Orcus, so you're going to have to help me get it back.
He knows where your soul is?
He gave it to the Tiamat.
What? What's the Tiamat? The Tiamat is a five-headed dragon that has laid waste to generations of civilizations.
and adventurers since the Babylonian times.
So it's pretty hard to kill?
That would be the logical conclusion, yes.
So you just gave her soul away? I should rip out your insides and dine them! Right here, right now, you have a good sad excuse for demonic instinct!
Whoa!
Ain't you the big bad baby girl?
What? No! You must be mistaking me for some other demon princess.
I don't think your daddy's gonna be too fond of you going AWOL.
Look, you can't tell him, okay? He'll kill me, kill me!
Now, suddenly you don't seem so tough.
Don't worry, he doesn't have any love for me either. Your secret's safe with me.
Tell us the location of the Tiamat Orcus now.
Fine. Go, go, Orcus back! Behold my comically large map of Nulandia! This is the path you must take if you wish to fight the Tiamat. First, you must travel along the River of Wetness to the Swamps of Mushy.
Names of these locations suck.
I was going to go back and get the pet name, but you know, I sort of died before I could get to it.
Then you must climb the Mountain of Steepness to the Castle of Evil. There you will find the Tiamat.
That seems simple enough.
What? To be able to face the Tiamat, first you must find and defeat all three of its guardians, the big bosses of Nulandia! And each one of them are totally badass. So most likely one, if not all of you, will die before you get there. So yeah, you gotta do that. Or, we can chill in my cave and rock at the Thursday Night Must See TV! Who's feeling me? No? None of you guys are in the ER? That Clooney cat is slamming.
Look, I can't ask for you all to come with me. The journey before us is too perilous and the prize too personal for me to expect you to risk your lives. I'm just one girl and you all have so much ahead of you. Please, if you do not wish to continue, you have my blessing to stay here and be safe.
Tilius, you know you always have my blade.
And mine.
Seriously, I'm totally fine with just chilling.
You don't get a choice.
Damn it.
What about you, Agnes the Dummy?
Agnes the Dummy? I thought my name was Agnes the Asshat.
It means the same thing.
Told you she was stupid.
What say you? Will you adventure with us?
Yeah, of course I will. Then let us kick it some ass.
Yeah.
And so, our team of adventurers set forth, following the map Orcus had traced out for them. It was indeed treacherous, and they did indeed kick his ass.
Seriously, did you see a sign on the way up here that said, "Pay
Fairies are happy. No one said nice. Happy. And I'm brimming like mad with some magical happiness. And did you know what makes me the happiest? Laying the smackdown on any lame adventurer who tries to trespass on my magically enchanted forest.
We could just take the long way around.
You're going to the mountain, as in the mountain of steepness?
As a matter of fact,
yes. What for?
To fight the Tiamat, if you need to know.
Oh, that's all you had to say, mortals?
Oh yeah?
Yeah, get ready to push down, cause it's throwdown time! I'm one of the great guardians, bitches!
I don't even know what that means. But I do know what it means.
No, man, it ain't like that. We just roleplay. What?
Got no feelings for her. Don't worry.
I mean, it was pretty clear that she was vibing on me and all when we first met. But I set the ground rules straight. This is just for fun. No long-term commitments. I'm just here to help her play out this fantasy of hers.
All right, I'm gonna break your...
Hey, Chuck, sorry I'm late, but check out what I found. I think they'll help me stay in character.
Hey.
Hey.
I think I should go.
Why?
Clearly busy.
Oh, God, you know about this now, don't you?
Yep.
You don't think I'm a dork, do you?
No, that's not what I'm thinking. Hey, you can join us if you want. If you're comfortable with it. You can watch us for a bit, and then once you get the hang of it,
you can jump right in. Don't worry. I'll go easy on you. Please, only things. Because I'm big, where it counts.
I'm gonna go.
Man.
That guy really doesn't like D&D,
does he?
Let's go.